Who here enjoys being watched by other people? Although I've done absolutely nothing wrong, and I'm up here just to tell you about how to stay safe. My heart is racing, my adrenaline is pumping through my veins, because I have 20 sets of eyes on me. I even feel strange when I have, you know, that thought that someone is watching me. Have you ever glanced over your shoulder real quick? Just to out of the blue maneuver. Maybe you see another human who is staring directly at you. But then you lock eyes. And you both exchange things that you didn't intend to share with this person. Being watched changes you, changes the way you feel, doesn't it? You feel different or exposed in your own body. So how can this information, this feeling, this dreaded experience that we go through be used or be implemented to protect us as citizens and as human beings? There are others that have asked this question, and there are others that have already found a possible solution to the dilemma. How do we thwart terrorists and other criminals from committing their atrocities before they occur in the first place? Between subliminal mind tricks and utilizing other human awareness practices, many crimes have been discouraged or prevented entirely. Scientists, researchers, and the United States military have implemented and reviewed the psychology behind the feeling that you get when you're being watched or when you feel that you're being watched. I'm here to tell you how the mind reacts, and how you can be a little safer for yourself and those in your life by keeping an eye out. Now, I hope you've been paying attention, because I'm Kyle Sharp, and I've been keeping an eye on you. What allows people to execute an act that would be considered illegal? Beyond actual cameras or security devices in that manner, what deters someone from disobeying common law and morality if they really wanted to? Now, other than just playing getting caught, is it the other people that are nearby in that area? Or is it just the simple thought or feeling that someone is there watching? In a study published in 2012 by Daniel Nettle, a behavioral researcher, biologist, and social scientist with the Center for Behavior and Evolution and the Institute of Neuroscience at Newcastle University, they put on a little research. They placed a poster above several different bike racks, and on this poster was a set of eyes, and in red lettering, "Bike thieves, we are watching you." And they also had their control of bike racks that did not have this poster placed above them. And after 12 months of recording bike thefts, the results had an obvious trend. The locations with the posters had a significantly lower theft rate. And get this, by a total of 62%. That is significant. So what does that do for us, though? Well, it's also up to us to make the difference. We could ask our local civil servants to have posters of watching eyes placed everywhere, but it doesn't stop those who are on a mission of criminal activity. It just pushes those on the fence away, seemingly. watchful eye of the everyday person is one of the greatest tools we have and have always had. During my time in the United States Army, I participated in, as well as organized, multiple training exercises on how to be a vigilant public servant as an everyday civilian. The military has outlined the basics of public surveillance and personal security as it relates to anti-terrorism. A community that is active with a healthy sense of paranoia, and I'm not talking foil hats here, but a suspicion and cognizance of the people and areas around you. However, this does not mean acting upon something you've seen. You most likely aren't MacGyver or Walker, Texas Ranger. So be sure to alert the local authorities to any suspicious findings you may have made during your reconnaissance. More information can be found on the jko.j10.mil website under Anti-Terrorism Level 1 Training if you'd like to delve deeper into what the military has to offer you and your own safety. So the last and first line of defense for your own personal safety, being said, is you. Always keep a healthy judgment of the people in a situation that surrounds you. Be sure to always be aware of your environment. Notice differences or changes in your own neighborhood. Don't try to intervene in a dangerous situation by yourself or at all. And be sure to alert the proper authorities during an emergency. I hope that you have taken something away from this and that you can help ensure the safety of your own neighborhood and your loved ones. Big Brother may not be watching you due to the Fourth Amendment, but I'll be keeping a wary eye. Thank you.